Okay, so I was telling you, when it comes to the domain and range and what values make sense, you just have to know what you're reading and what you're dealing with, okay? So you have to ask yourself, what is happening in this function? If I'm buying pencils, it has to be whole numbers. If I'm buying calculators, it has to be whole numbers. If I'm buying computers, it has to be whole numbers. If I am buying sugar, I can buy half a kilogram. I can buy 3/4 kilogram. I can buy 2 kilograms and a half. So you have to know when you can use whole numbers, when you can use integers, when you can use rational numbers. When you can only use positive rational numbers. If I am measuring the distance from here to Dubai, my answer can be a decimal. My answer can be a fraction, but it can only be positive. Distance can never be negative. Yes, if my question is about money, yes, my question is about money, I need to know I can have money in terms of decimals, like that. You need to think what your question is about. It is up to you to read and think. Okay? So let's continue. So here, my domain has to be whole numbers because I cannot buy jars of peanut. I cannot buy jars in fractions. So it has to be whole numbers. And when I say whole numbers, you should know I mean positive numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3. So on X, my first value has to be 0. It cannot be negative. It cannot. Okay? So then I knew that this would be my equation or my function. So then I have to do my table for me to make a decision of what my range will be. So I looked at my range. And I saw all my answers are multiples of 770. 770 times 0 is 0. 770 times 1 is 770. 770 times 2, 1540. Times 3. So these are multiples of 770. So I wrote here, the range has to be multiples of 770 because it depends on the domain. I need the domain to multiply with my slope to give me the range. That's what I wrote. Now, write a function to represent the total number. So my function will be f of j is equals to 770 j. Or what did they say? I use p of j. They told me to use p of j. So I'm going to use p of j. There. There is my function. Then find out when you have 13 jars. So P of 13 is equal to 770 bracket 13. And then I get P of 13, 770 times 13. One. 0010. So that is 10,010. Okay. So then I answer in a complete sentence. There are 10,010 peanuts in 13 jars of peanut butter. If I have 13 jars of peanut butter, I will have 10,010 peanuts. So I need 10,010 peanuts to make 13 peanuts, to make 13 jars of peanut butter. I need 770 peanuts to make one jar of peanut butter. Okay? So that's what we're supposed to do. Do your examples. After you do your examples, we'll talk about them tomorrow.